Hello viewers, welcome to Damu Education. If not yet subscribed, please subscribe and click the bell icon. So in this module, we are going to discuss our last question, that is 7th one. So what they are given here is, they are given one triangle ABC, that is equilateral triangle. So they are telling that this equilateral triangle, and what we have to show here is, each and every angle in this triangle, we have to show that is 60 degrees. How to show it is 60 degrees is, so we need to take things like it is isosceles triangle. So based on that, we have to move on this. So let's consider AB and AC. So this is the sides are all equal. So from isosceles triangle, what you can say here is, so we have to take RTP. What is required to prove here is, angle A equal to angle B equal to angle C will be equal to 60 degrees. So we have to show this one. Angle A, angle B, angle C, both are all are angles are 60 degrees. So based on this, what we have to take it here is, so let's consider angles. So these are the angles. So let's consider angle A, angle B, then angle C. So these are all angles are, let's take x degrees. So we don't know what is that degrees, but keep it like this. So here from triangle, so from triangle ABC, what is there given? So AB equal to, in equilateral triangle, all the sides are equal. So in equilateral triangle, so what you can say, in equilateral triangle, all the sides are equal. Three sides are equal. Three sides are equal. So that is, equilateral means all the laterals are equal. That is, AB will be equal to BC will be equal to CA. So this is the condition. And if AB and AC will be equal to means, then opposite sides for these two sides are also equal. So let's consider this is, let's consider, so for this opposite sides, so let's consider AB from, what you can say, from AB and AC, from AB and AC, what you can say here is angle ABC, angle AB, AB equal to AC, right? So for that, what you can write, for this angles also equal, that is angle ABC will be equal to angle ACB, angle ACB. So these two angles are equal, that is nothing but your angle B will be equal to angle C. So angle B will be equal to angle C, that is angles, let's take this is the first equation. And from, so angle B equal to angle C, this is angle B, this is angle C, this is angle A. So these angles, we took it like that. Now, next one, from what you can say, from AB and AC are we taken, and then next combination AB and BC, AB and BC. Then what you can write it here, AB equal to BC, as we know that AB equal to BC. For these opposite angles, AB and, so this AB and what is this BC? For these two opposite angles, so what we will get? So BAC is equal to, BAC will be equal to BCA. So BCA. So these two angles will be equal for these two sides. So for these two combination, these two sides, these two angles are equal. That is, angle A will be equal to angle C. So angle A will be equal to angle C. This is, let's take from equation 2. Next combination. So AC finished and BC over, then we have to take AB as two angles are equal. So that, for that you need to take combination of A and AC. So from what you can say, from AC and CB, from AC and CB, what combination? AC and CB, what you can write it here is AC will be equal to CB. AC will be equal to CB. For that, what angles? CAB, angle CAB will be equal to, angle CAB will be equal to, what you can write? Angle CBA, CBA. So since from these two, what you can write it here is, so angle A will be equal to angle B. So let's take this is equation 3. From all these equations, what you can write it here is, so we can write from 1 and 2, from 1, 2 and 3, what you can write, all the angles are equal to each other. That is, angle B will be equal to C, then angle A will be equal to So this is equation 1 and this is equation 2 and this is equation 3. So from these equations, angle A will be equal to angle C, then angle A will be equal to angle B. Then what you can write it here? So these are the combinations what we have to take. So since therefore angle A will be equal to angle B will be equal to angle C. So this one we can write angle A equal to angle B equal to angle C. Let's take all these angles will be equal to some x degrees. So angle A will be equal to angle B will be equal to angle C will be equal to some x degrees. So that is the angle, we know that this is x degrees. So this is x degrees and this is also x degrees. So what we have to take is 60 degrees means here sum of all these angles. So in triangle, what is that? So sum of three angles will be equal to 180 degrees. So total angle in the triangle, that is 180 degrees. So let's combination of sum of angle sum property. So sum of angles. So what is that? Angle A plus angle B plus angle C will be equal to 180 degrees. So sum of all these angles are equal to 180 degrees. For that, what you can write? X degrees plus X, that is 180 degrees. Then all, how many X's are there in the addition? 3 X's. So that is 3 X degrees will be equal to 180. Then X will be equal to 180 by 3. So 3 ones are, then 3 60s are. That is X will be equal to 60 degrees. So X will be equal to 60 degrees. As we know, X will be equal to 60 degrees. Here also 60 degrees. Here also 60 degrees. So if you add all these angles, we will get 60, 60, 60. As a combination of it is, we'll get 180 degrees. So by that, we can say all 6 threes are 80. So like that, we need to find. This is the way to find the angles in the given equilateral triangle. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.